All right, we are back with Jen Lilley. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good, thanks. Thank you. The prettiest green eyes.
I was just thinking you have pretty eyes.
They're like striking.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Thank my parents.
I will.
Good genes.
Write them a letter. So fall is upon us. So all of our favorite TV shows are back.
Yes.
I need the rundown. What are you watching this season?
Dexter is my favorite all-time show. I'm obsessed with it, and I am so sad that there's only one season left. Michael C. Hall is amazing, but my favorite is Jennifer Carpenter, who plays Deb. She's brilliant.
Were you sad when they got divorced? Little side note.
I was sad, but I try not to like ever read any tabloids or anything, so I'm kind of like to each his own, whatever is, I think everything's like that is private, so. See, but I'm impressed that they can work
together.
Yeah,
when I started watching it, I went in knowing that they had been divorced, because I went in seasons late.
Yeah.
I can't believe, like, true testament to their acting, because
they're
incredible
amazing.
Together.
Yeah, and they're really, really good.
Okay,
so
sorry.
Definitely Dexter.
Go on, yeah.
That's my favorite. And then who doesn't love Modern Family? The Middle, I love The Middle. Eden Scher, I think she deserves her own category of Emmy. The girl who plays Sue, she's ridiculous.
I haven't seen The Middle.
Oh my gosh, where are you from originally?
L.A.
So you might not get it.
Where are you from?
It's like from the middle of Midwest. I'm from Virginia.
Okay.
So it's like every Midwest family.
Okay. So I'll give it a shot.
Yeah, I like The Middle, Modern Family. I mean, who doesn't like The New Girl?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I like a lot of the comedies.
Yeah, we actually had Kelly Hawk on one of our episodes.
Did you?
Yes.
She's very good.
Yes, she
very,
is.
Very talented.
I'm excited for her second season with Winston.
Mm-hmm.
But enough of that. Okay, so one show that is not seasonal is General Hospital.
Yes.
It's on every single day.
Every single day.
And you had a long run on it.
I did. I was really lucky. It was supposed to be 2 weeks. It turned up to be 11 months. And it's amazing. The fans are incredible.
Okay, but how was it playing? Because you're so sweet. How is it playing Maxie, who's kind of a
witch? I actually loved playing Maxie. I mean, she had vulnerable moments. I got to explore a lot of things. She went to jail. I had like a prison storyline, which is really fun for me because I am totally not typecast as like the person that's in jail. It was a lot of fun. I mean, every actor wants to play somebody that's not exactly like them. So I loved it.
So now you just left recently. Is it nice not having a book this big of a script to read every single night?
It is nice to have my nights back. I mean, before, basically, we shoot 150 pages a day. A normal show shoots 7 pages a day. So I would have 40 pages of dialogue, my own dialogue a day. So I would literally, like, get home, change into sweatpants, and, like, eat my dinner while I'm watching, like, The New Girl trying to catch up, you know? And then you gotta pause it, and then you gotta go right back to the 40 pages and get up at, like, 4:30 to go back to set. So it was really crazy.
Is this
definitely, I'm glad to have my nights back.
Is this like an innate talent, memorizing lines, or that? I mean, that sounds insane. I never knew.
Yeah, I don't know. You just get used to it. I think it's like any skill. You know, the longer you do it, the better you get at it, I guess.
Huh. Very impressive, I must say. I could never do that. So you've gone from reading, I hear, to now writing.
I am. I'm writing a children's story with my family, which is a lot of fun. Yeah.
Are they still in Virginia?
They are still in Virginia. So that's kind of been tricky, getting the drafts back and forth. You kind of get stuck in Virginia a lot of the time. Like, send me your draft back. But it's a lot of fun.
Can you tell us a little bit about what the story is going to be about?
I don't know if I should, but I will say it's a children's story. And my grandfather orally invented it and told it to my mom, and my mom told it to us. So we're kind of writing it as a family, and my little sister is possibly illustrating it.
Okay, this is not fair.
Little.
This is the cutest family that ever existed.
Thank you.
Oh my
gosh. But it's probably going to be called the Salami Stories. So they're fun.
Salami, is there a reason why?
That's the little boy's name.
Salami? Is there a salami in your family?
No. No, that would be really weird if there was. But anyway.
Might be a little more normal, just throwing it out there.
It's kind of like Amelia Bedelia, you know? It's just like, gotcha. There's like a lot of rhyming, and it's a lot of fun. So I'll keep you guys posted on when it comes out. Yeah.
Is it the final draft? Is it coming out soon?
Oh God, I hope so. No, I think we probably have like 3 more drafts to do.
Wow.
But we're getting there.
So books take forever.
They do take forever. Especially
kids'
stories.
Really?
Yeah, you wouldn't think. But there's a lot to it, so.
Okay, I have a niece who's 2 and a niece who's 6. Which one would it be more geared towards?
Both, actually.
What a saleswoman! Oh my gosh. I'm just kidding. Yeah, yeah, they're all kind of the same.
Well, it depends. Like, the 2-year-old would learn some and the 6-year-old would learn some. It's kind of educational as well, which children's books should be, I think.
Mm. Well, Jen, you're a very impressive woman.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for sitting down with us. It was a pleasure talking to you, and good luck with everything, and I can't wait to read the book. That's a little embarrassing since it's a children's book, but I'll definitely be reading it.
You'll love it.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you so much.
Bye, guys.
Bye.